Well, vaccinations are slowing down, according to Health Minister the Honorable Michael Darvall, who assured, though, that the government is working on plans to keep the COVID-19 vaccination drive going.
It is our responsibility to now go to the people in smaller, different vaccination, mobile units, different places, to make life easier for individuals who want to be vaccinated. As we speak, the vaccination committee, as well as members in my ministry, are exploring all of the avenues. We realize that at 40%, like many other parts of the world, we're now approaching the time when we are beginning to see some areas of vaccination hesitancy. These things are being explored, and it is our responsibility to move swiftly, along with our partners, inclusive of the United States, to assist us to ensure that we maximize the vaccines that we have in country.
My name is Camille Barnett, and I'm president of the Bahamas AIDS Foundation. During these difficult times, we have continued to provide support to our clients through a number of initiatives. We provide weekly grocery support and hot meals. Our clients have access to counseling and a food and clothing bank, as well as assistance with clinic visits and medications. Access to our social worker enables clients to get support with job preparation, securing government documents, and negotiating the everyday trials of life. We're also committed to making sure our young people have academic support through the provision of laptops and school supplies, funds for school registration, and national examination fees. The foundation is proud of our Solomon Wellington Adley Memorial Scholarship, which supports two university students. Our foundation and its volunteers work to positively impact the lives of our clients. It is important work that must continue. In order to continue our work, we need your support. You can support the Bahamas AIDS Foundation by visiting our website at www.bahamasaidsfoundation.org and selecting one of the methods for donating and by participating in our awareness activities, especially as we approach World AIDS Day on December the 1st. I wish to thank all of our supporters and donors over the years. We cannot do what we do without the support of generous members of our community. Thank you.